Hi all, Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at two two-beam laser levels from the Chinese company, CLUBIONA. They differ in both laser color and housing. As the video progresses, I will tell you how to use these laser levels. And how to choose a two-beam laser level to suit your needs. If you are interested in devices for the home handyman, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. Let's figure out why these laser levels are needed. And then we'll delve into the capabilities and technical characteristics of these devices. What are they used for? 1. Hanging pictures, cabinets. 2. Installation of sockets and switches. 3. Installation of electrical and gas equipment. 4. Marking horizontal and vertical routes for pipes and electrical wiring on the wall, as well as marking flat routes on the ceiling. 5. Laying tiles and wall panels. 6. Laying bricks and wall blocks, marking the location of building structure elements. 7. The use of inclined beams will help when creating design solutions, as well as when installing stairs. Compared to a regular bubble level, no marking with a pencil or marker is required, as you can immediately work with the lines displayed by the laser level. Using these lines, we can immediately visually determine how much we have deviated from the vertical or horizontal. Using laser markings, we can immediately make holes in the wall or align wall blocks or tiles. This allows you to work faster and more accurately. Compared to powerful 12-beam laser levels, 2-beam laser levels are much smaller in size, which allows them to be taken to almost any object. They work much longer on batteries, as they consume less electricity. Since their design is simpler and contains fewer lasers, the reliability of these devices is much higher. This device is LD02G with a green laser. It has a rubberized body. The case dimensions are 885.5 cm. On top there is a button that forcibly turns on the lasers. Let's turn it off here. We press a button and our lasers are turned on forcibly. In this case, the mechanism of the device is blocked, and we can slant the lines. This allows you to build inclined planes and inclined lines. The lasers blink once every 4 seconds, indicating that this mode is enabled. Hold the button again and this mode turns off. At the bottom there is a switch that turns on the device mode with a self-leveling function. If your device is already on a flat surface, then the device produces a horizontal and vertical line within 3 seconds. If the device is on an inclined surface, and the slope is more than 4 degrees, then the lines flash, indicating that the mechanism of the device cannot compensate for this slope, and the device needs to be leveled. I usually use this round level to preset the position of the device. This is especially true if you use a tripod to install a laser level on site. And this is the MD02RS device with a red laser. It's entirely plastic. What I like about this device is that it is practically a cube, and all the edges of which are located at an angle of 90 degrees. The case dimensions are 7.77 cm. This makes it easier to work with the device when you lean it against vertical surfaces. I'll show you what I mean a little later. The device can also operate in either a locked mechanism or self-leveling mode. The device modes are switched by a switch on the side. This is how it is in self-leveling mode. This way the mechanism is locked and we can build inclined lines. And now the device is turned off. Please note that the lines, when the mechanism is locked, unlike the previous device, do not blink at all. If the device is placed on an inclined surface, the lines will also flash. A round level will also help us adjust the position of the device. Both devices are powered by 2Ah batteries. They are not included in the package. The green laser level consumes 3 times more current than the red one. The consumption of the device with the red laser showed 75 milliamperes, but the green one showed 220 milliamperes. The multimeter did not sense the consumption of laser levels when it was turned off. But I still recommend removing batteries from devices during long-term storage, as they can leak. Both devices have a 1/4 tripod mount on the bottom. The distance from the bottom of the device to the horizontal line for the green device is slightly more than 4 centimeters. For the cube, it is slightly less than 4 centimeters. Both devices have a protection class of IP54, which protects against the entry of small splashes and dust. But this device should not be used in the rain. The stated accuracy of the devices is 2 millimeters at 5 meters. So I superimposed the lines of two laser levels, they practically coincide. Both devices comply with the Eurotest standard. The laser level may include a fabric case with a belt mount like this. Passports are included in the kit, but there is more from this video about these levels than from these passports. Laser levels were supplied in these boxes. They are quite sturdy and can be used to transport instruments from site to site. You can find out more information about these levels at the link in the description. Let's move on to practical tests. I mounted the laser level on a tripod. This is a regular camera tripod. For the initial adjustment of the device, I used a round level. It can be removed. Here we have two crossed lines, vertical and horizontal. If we need the lines to be higher, then we can use a selfie stick. So I put a laser level on a selfie stick. As you can see, it is almost under the ceiling. Here's our tripod. I modernized the selfie stick a little. I told you what I did for this in another video. I left the link in the description. We see two crossed lines. We can rotate the horizontal line by turning the handle on the tripod. We can also draw a horizontal line along all four walls by turning the laser level. But it is more convenient to do this using a 360 degrees laser level. We can fix the laser level mechanism and mark electrical wiring routes on the ceiling. We can also rotate it downwards and place the position of the tiles on the floor. But it is more convenient to mark the ceiling and floor using laser levels with a 360 degree scan. So I placed two levels, one on top of the other. Here are the lines they display on the wall. Please note that the green line is slightly wider horizontally, and the red line is slightly higher vertically. This can be justified by the different designs of instrument housings. We see the vertical lines are parallel. We can combine them. The vertical lines almost coincide. Let's look at the divergence of the horizontal lines. As you can see, on the wall there is 7.5 centimeters between the lines. Near the devices themselves, this distance is the same. You can also notice that the green beam is much brighter. Outdoors, it is preferable to use a laser level with a green beam. Let's see how prepared the surface for the window sill is. As you can see, the window sill level is set well. And if you look at the slope, you can see that it needs to be adjusted a little. Now I'll show you why I like the square body of the laser level. So I apply it to the wall, and the level is immediately shown to me. I can, if I wish, drill straight away without placing the wall. You can set the laser level by eye, because if we tilt it, it starts to blink. Or you can use this level, which I use to install sockets. Let's see how another laser level will behave. So I put it against the wall and it blinks. I can try to adjust it, but I won't succeed, since this laser level is narrowed at the top. So for it to stop blinking, I have to move the top part of the device a little away from the wall. and only then does it show the level. And this is not very convenient. Same thing with the back wall. It tapers slightly at the top. And for the device to stop blinking, you need to tilt it forward a little. Only then will the laser level stop blinking. And this is also inconvenient. So I leaned the cubic level against the wall, and it immediately drew us the correct level. If you will be using a level in this manner, a cube level is preferable. General impressions about these devices. If I were now choosing a two-beam laser level, I would choose something in between these two devices. I would choose a laser level in a cube body, but with a green laser. This manufacturer, CLUBIONA, has such a device, and it is labeled MD02GS. This will allow them to work outside. At the same time, you need to accept that it will use up batteries 3 times faster. To ensure the power lasts longer, it is better to use alkaline batteries. Although, I only buy these anyway. The parameters of the devices suit me. They hold the plane well. The lines of the instruments practically coincide, which indicates good adjustment of the instruments. If you have any questions about these laser levels, ask them in the comments. If you know other examples of how to use similar devices, write about it in the comments. I think other viewers will find this interesting. I left the link where I ordered the devices in the description. Share the video with those who might be interested in these levels. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos. Like and see you in new and old videos.